What's up, guys? It's Jake here from Chief Life Gaming. Today, an update on the Thunderhawk gunship. So, basically, what I'm going to do is record a few clips over the next couple days of sort of the whole building slash assembling process, and I'll probably put those clips all together into one video for you guys so you can see kind of the process coming together, just what I've kind of been doing. So, we've prepped, trimmed, and washed all of the resin components. You see them all here. There are quite a few pieces in this kit and only 5 pages of directions. Very, very easy, or very, what's the word? They're not very comprehensive instructions, as Forge World, this is an older Forge World kit, I believe. The instructions are not great, so it'll be fun to get this guy together. Their newer instruction booklets, interestingly enough, on the newer kits are amazing, so definitely upped their game there. But this kit should be pretty straightforward, hopefully. I say that now, we'll find out. So, basic resin prep, just a quick rundown. For those of you guys who maybe are newer to Forge World, or any resin kits, really. Basically, when they mold this stuff, you need to put a silicone, I'm assuming their molds are silicone-based, mold release into the mold before you get the resin in there so that it demolds better, basically. And it's oily and gross, and if you don't get it off of the resin pieces when they get shipped to you, your primer won't stick as well, and then your paint job will come off and just generally not go very well. So it's important to prep the resin pieces to not run into that problem. Just some Dawn or dish soap in a little jug of water. You know, dunk your resin pieces in here, and I use some old toothbrushes to really get in there and scrub the crap out of these resin pieces. I even had some help today to do that, and it took us a while. A few hours to do all these pieces, and I also trimmed sort of the preliminary amount of excess resin chunks that are from the molding process off of all the pieces so they're a little more workable as we move forward. And I'll just give you guys a look at all the pieces. I didn't really organize them or anything by the components, but it's still cool to see sort of what we've got going on here. A lot of engine components, a lot of hull components, wing stuff. A very neat kit. As far as this specific kit, as I've come accustomed to with these larger flyers, there is a little bit of warping. So if you guys are building anything like this, or I did a Fire Raptor once that was very, very warped as well. Basically, what happens is, if we take a look, you might be able to tell. If we look down this, say this, the front is at this plane. By the time you get to the back, it kind of is twisted like that. So the whole thing kind of is not perfectly straight from front to back, basically. It kind of ends up, again, doing that little twist. And that's, I don't know, it's not really the fault of anybody at Forge World, I don't think, because just the nature of molding something this big, you're going to get a little warp. So, like, this one's really obvious. It's just bent. And this guy here is a little crooked, but the good news is it's fixable. So, you just use heat and basically can heat these up and get them a little more malleable and work them into the correct shape, and then they will bend for you. So, heat gun or hair dryer, hot water works, but I prefer like the hair dryer method, just a little easier. If you have a nice hair dryer, your wife / girlfriend does, that you don't get in trouble for borrowing, that might be the way to go. So, next step, I have to finish prepping this resin. I'm letting it dry in front of the fan here right now, and once it's fully dry, probably tomorrow, I'll give it overnight, I will continue trimming all of the rest. Like, I've just kind of started trimming the excess crap off and begin assembly. So I'll come back to you guys with an update as soon as something else interesting happens with assembly. See you guys in a second. Okay, guys, so started assembly on this Thunderhawk, and we've got through the first sheet of three. Yeah, there's only three sheets of instructions, double-sided, for this beast. So basically, you can see that the cockpit, or kind of control center pilot area in the front, that sits into this lower, basically this is a large piece of hull that is the front bottom, basically, and then the maw here bolts kind of to the front and connects everything together. So you have to take this piece here, which is the cockpit, fit it onto the lower hull, and then smack the maw up from the front and kind of connect everything, and then there's this ceiling piece here. And I was looking at these instructions, guys. I was concerned, I'll have to say, just because of the amount of warping that I saw in this kit and bending. I was concerned that the pieces would not click together very well or fit together. So what I want to do before we take an in-depth look at this kit is show you. So here's the front, and you can see there is not very much gap. I am impressed with the way that this kit went together, I have to say. So that's the one that went to the front. And then if we look on the top, you can see the cockpit. Again, a little bit of a gap there, but that's not bad at all. You can see the cockpit area here. The largest gap by far was this one here, and that's just because this is a piece, a small corner piece, and it was not quite lined up, or it was a little warped, I'm not quite sure. But very acceptable considering what we had going on here, all the parts that I had to basically get together. So, again, I was worried, but it went together really, really well. I did have to use my hairdryer, bend some things just a little bit, nothing crazy. This cockpit part, again, wasn't very flat. I think I showed that in the last clip. It kind of was bending up in one of the corners. So we just heated that up and made it flat, and everything kind of went together reasonably well. So you can see that this is kind of a bulkhead. There's actually detail on the ceiling in here, which is pretty cool. So we've got like a compartment there. I'll show you guys. You've kind of been looking at this cockpit as I've been spinning things around, a lot of control panels, and there are pilots that sit in here, and then a couple chairs that bolt down there. But I'm leaving that unassembled until I paint it, because screw that, basically. So you can see in the front here, hopefully the light's getting in there reasonably well. Let's maybe, yeah, we're not gonna get a very good angle here, are we? You can see there's a lot of detail in this kit on the interior. Now, after talking to my client, we have decided to avoid painting the interior. He does want this to be a bit of a budget commission, so tabletop standard, you know, nothing insanely detailed. So in the interest of his budget and interest of time, we're going to not paint the interior, but we are going to paint this pilot cockpit area, because there is an open canopy on this plane, the ship, and you will be able to see inside, and I think that'll be a very cool thing to have painted up, and then we can kind of save time and budget on all that inside there. So I have assembled it to this point to sort of with that in mind. And so there it is. That's the first sheet. Impressed so far. Let's see how the rest of the kit goes together. Quick little update, guys. As I'm looking at this now, I just dry fit the sort of canopy cockpit covering for the hull on the top of the ship. And I realized that you don't really see a whole lot. Now, in the previous clip, I was worried about painting stuff back in here, but really, if we dry fit this just loosely, we'll leave that gap there even, that's fine. You don't see hardly anything in the cockpit. And then if we put the canopy cover on loosely, again, dry fit, you really don't see a whole lot in there, other than I have to clean up this canopy because the windows are all jagged. But that's good news, because I think, now I might regret this later, I think I'm going to glue it all together and then leave this canopy cover off and just paint around in here, because I think it's reasonable to be able to get enough detail in here with my paintbrush for what, basically for what you're actually going to see. I think it will look fine. So that's the plan. We're going to glue it all together. Moving along pretty well here. The kit is actually not too bad. I'm impressed. So let's see how the rest goes. Okay guys, so here it is, fully built. There wasn't anything really along the way and until this point really that I thought needed a clip for this video. Really a pretty straightforward kit, guys. Honestly, I would rather put together one of these than a Fire Raptor, for sure. Fire Raptor was a pain. I think that because this kit was so big, it actually helped in a little bit of a way to line things up correctly and get things snug. So the only scary part, this whole piece in the back is very big, and it goes from about right here all the way to the back corner, and you have to line up basically the back of the hull and the top part here, and then all the whole side. So it took some brute force and a lot of scary clicks and cracks as that got settled in the right spot. It wasn't the resin like breaking, but it's just getting things snug. You get that little click going on, and it was a little nerve-wracking, but we got it on there. A little bit of heat, a little bit of brute force, and it all sat on there pretty nice. So I'll just give you guys a look as I talk a little closer at this awesome model. I know there are a couple of you guys that have been like messaging me on Instagram and stuff about kind of my thoughts and my tips that I have for this build. Honestly guys, it's pretty straightforward. Don't be intimidated because this kit's so big. It was fairly easy to put together. It took me about 5 hours to assemble, and that was not including the resin prep. So, you know, that's a long time, but really it's not for something this size, and I was a little bit surprised that it didn't take me longer. So this was one of the bigger gaps we had. Some green stuff work to do on this guy. Other than that though, it's looking pretty cool. We've got the magnetizing. We decided to avoid that because if you look at this kit, if we were to magnetize these really big wings, you know, you take the wing off, you've still got this thing sticking out and this, so you are gaining a little bit of room on each side, maybe 3 or 4 inches off of each side for your storage, but it's not really going to make that big of a difference unless we want to magnetize here and here, and you know, didn't really want to do that for a couple reasons. So if we look at this from the front, this is why I recommend gluing. If you think about the length of the wingspan, it's like 19 inches or something. If you are going to magnetize something, right, you put magnets in the wing, magnets in the hull, and the one issue you can run into with that is when you set the magnets inside of the resin, it can be difficult to get things to meet perfectly flush as if you would glue it. I don't know if this is making sense, but basically if it's not seating when it's all magnetized in there, flush and pulled nice and evenly to the hull, this, by the time you get out to the wing, even if it's only off like a couple degrees, the wing will be, you know, a half an inch or a few mil higher, and it'll look crooked. So that's not something I wanted to fiddle with. It would be a challenge, I think, to get the wings perfectly even. And I measured the distance, the verticality from the tip of the wing to the basically the surface of the table on both sides. I was only off by an eighth of an inch. So that is definitely acceptable tolerance for me. Now, that's the main reason, really, why I decided to try to suggest to my client to avoid the magnetization, just because we weren't going to gain a whole lot of storage space, and the potential for the wings to not look right was high, and for me to get them right would have taken a lot of time and therefore a lot of the budget. So that's kind of where we ended up. Now we've got the plasma laser destroyer D weapon on top, hard mounted, because, I mean, honestly, why would you bring the other gun? This thing is awesome. And I think that's about all I have to say. We did, obviously, assemble the front. So I'm gonna do my best to get my brush in here to paint inside the cockpit area. I think it's going to be fine because as you put the canopy cover on, I don't have it in this room, but there's just little cutouts where you see through. So it's not like it's got to be ultra detailed as if it was like a clear glass canopy cover where you can see every little thing inside. As long as it's painted, well, you know, it doesn't have to be ultra detail inside there and it will do just fine. So that's about all I wanted to tell you guys. Maybe let's see if I can even really wield this thing one-handed. Here's the bottom. It's quite heavy, so I'm not going to hold it for too long here. I did put the landing gear up so that you have the option to you know, set it on the table like this instead of on the flight stand. So I wanted to give you guys an idea of scale here. So that's the Space Marine in power armor. Here's a Riptide, one of my Riptides. That's a big plane, guys. A very cool ship, a very cool project. So next steps, we're gonna end this video with this clip. I'm not going to extend the video itself too long. So in the next video, I'm going to have done the green stuff work. We're going to prime and begin painting. And I might do a couple little clips through the painting process. I'm not too sure how much I'm going to actually cover that. But we will for sure have a showcase video when I finish this project. So thanks a lot for watching, guys. I hope it's been helpful and interesting. I know that, again, I've been getting a lot of messages about basically questions on the kit from people that are thinking about buying one or thinking about putting one together. If you guys do have any questions, feel free to ask. I'll do my best to answer down below. So hopefully this has helped you guys out just a little bit and given you a better idea of what to expect for your own Thunderhawk gunship. Again, Gray Knights is my client request, so that will be the paint scheme. Should be a good one. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Bye now.